Do not overlook the relationship between iron deficiency and hypothyroidism. Beyond the fact that both conditions have many overlapping symptoms like fatigue, hair loss, depression, and just an overall sense of decreased life performance, literally decreased life performance, iron and thyroid hormone activity are tightly connected. And literally, neither one can thrive without the other. So hit that subscribe button, click the little bell to be notified when there's a new video. And as always, I'll be hanging out in the comment section for about 30 minutes after the video is released, just responding to any comments, concerns, questions you guys have. So I have had no shortage of patients over the years who came thinking that they were hypothyroid, low thyroid function, and ended up being iron deficient, or came in thinking, man, I gotta be iron deficient. My friend was iron deficient. And it actually ended up being low thyroid function. Or they end up having, low iron levels and hypothyroidism. And so many times solving one, solve the other. Or we even had to just solve both of them. So why is this? Well, I have six considerations that you and your doctor can investigate. And I want to encourage you, if you felt like you were just never going to find an answer to how you feel or get out of your current health despair, that led you to watching this video in the first place, do not give up and keep turning over rocks. So the first thing is iron deficiency can lead to reduced activity of the deiodinases. These are enzymes responsible for converting T4 thyroid hormone to T3 thyroid hormone within cells. And this can result in a lower intracellular level of T3. So T3 is the most active form of thyroid hormone. If T3 levels go down, then cellular metabolism is compromised, and that leads to symptoms of hypothyroidism, even if circulating levels of T4 are normal. And this is big time because so many people have been told your T4 labs are good, normal, and are having, thyroid symptoms. They're suffering needlessly. All right, number two, both iron and thyroid hormones can influence oxidative stress within cells. So T3's action is to increase metabolic activity and to consume oxygen essentially in the cell. However, this naturally leads to a bunch of reactive oxygen species being produced, also known as free radicals. So iron, on the other hand, is a key component of antioxidant enzymes like catalase and superoxide dismutase, which their job is to clear these reactive oxygen species or free radicals. If iron levels are inadequate, then cellular damage can occur, even though the thyroid hormones are doing their job properly. And this is good reason to look at, a strong antioxidant support along with normalizing your iron, given that oxidative stress is going to be, over the top, kind of overwhelming the cells. All right, thirdly, iron is a crucial component of the enzyme thyroid peroxidase, or TPO. And this enzyme is necessary for the synthesis of thyroid hormones. Without optimal iron levels, TPO activity decreases. And this leads to reduced thyroid hormone production. This is also why we really want to look at the sources of inflammation or chronic infection when we're trying to support thyroid activity and iron utilization. And that leads me to the next one. Chronic inflammation, can lead to sequestering of iron, slowing down thyroid activity, which leads to even more inflammation. This is why you need to look at your whole body, the whole lab profile, not just one single lab test and make your decision on that. So hypothyroidism or low thyroid function, if it's not managed, it can lead to a state of chronic low-grade inflammation. Inflammatory cytokines, they have this heavy influence on iron metabolism by promoting retention of iron within white blood cells. And those cells are called macrophages, which then reduces the availability for erythropoiesis, which is red blood cell production. That's like literally pouring gasoline on the fire, right? Because in a hypothyroid state, the production of transferrin can be reduced. And this is because thyroid hormones are responsible for stimulating the synthesis of countless proteins, and in this case, transferrin. without sufficient transferrin, this one's overlooked all the time, the transport of iron throughout the body is compromised. Transferrin's job is to transport iron safely in the bloodstream to the liver for storage, to the brain for utilization, to the bone marrow for red blood cell creation. It's no wonder low thyroid, low iron, like brain fog all over the place, right? So both iron deficiency and hypothyroidism, you know, they share common symptoms such as weakness, fatigue, cold, all that kind of stuff. And this overlap makes it challenging to diagnose the root cause of these symptoms, you know, without just doing broad spectrum testing. I think we need to do more of it. So check out my other videos to get important, you know, tidbits on and what testing you can do to make sure you're not missing out. Because as iron goes down, thyroid goes down. As thyroid goes down, iron goes down. It just keeps compounding on itself. And you know, if it's not treated, man, life's just not gonna be very enjoyable. However, man, if you put your foot down and say, you know what, I'm gonna figure this out, we're gonna find this out. If this doctor doesn't help me out, I'm going to this doctor. You are gonna find the answer. And you are gonna come out of a hypothyroid state, you're gonna come out of an iron deficiency state. You might even find that it's neither one of those. Once you don't, those look fantastic. And it's actually this over here, because I actually did comprehensive testing. I didn't just say, give me a TSH level for the thyroid. Give me a, you know, a ferritin level. Give me a CBC for the iron. No, comprehensive. All right, check them out in the videos related to testing, and check out the link below for the optimized iron guide. You do not want to miss it. It'll help move you down that road. So you know you have a path to go on to optimizing your iron and making sure that is not what is getting in the way of you, you know, maximizing your health outcomes. And I would love it, man, if you could comment below about your story related to hypothyroidism or your story related to iron deficiency, how you overcame or where you're at in your journey. It is so helpful to help everybody else who's also searching for answers to see if your story lines up with their story. All right, keep accumulating health. I'll talk to you guys later.